Howdy, y'all. Round the wheel here. We are now approaching Tube Electric. I think the first three worlds in Jazz Jackrabbit are iconic. There we go. Grab ourselves a little shield. We're set up with shield and bird. That's a good start. Tube Electric, a really iconic level. These three levels all together, I think, are kind of iconic. Mostly because they got shared to shareware. Shareware. Another great concept from the early 90s. Kind of a way to combat piracy. People thought you would be more likely to play their game if you got a taste of maybe the first episode or the first few levels. And I don't know how much that bore out, because I don't know that I ever bought a full version of any game that I played on shareware. I don't think I played a full version of any game I bought on shareware until much later, when the concept was kind of obsolete. So, did shareware do the job? Did it not? I'd say it was pretty good, at least for cultural penetration. I mean, I still remember today, like, Commander Keen and all that. Those games were very big on shareware. Take a bit to the right. There's a one up there. I'm remembering all the basic stuff. Very good. But yeah, here we are, just ripping through tubes. Sonic the Hedgehog usually waits until a lot later to introduce the concept of tubes in its games, I find. Jazz Jackrabbit started tubing it up immediately. But there I go comparing Sonic the Hedgehog and Jazz the Jackrabbit. Jazz the Jackrabbit. That is not the name of the game. He is just Jazz Jackrabbit. He does not have a middle name. And if he did, it would certainly not be the. I think it would be Fusion. Let's go. Let's have at it here. God, I love that bass that opens that. I've become such a bass head in my old age. Like, if I have a midlife crisis, it's going to be getting a bass guitar. Whoa, hey, hi. Don't want to lose the bird just yet. I feel like the bird will be the first to go if I get hit. I think it depends on, honestly, which hitbox gets hit. But I think the bird is going to be the first thing to go if I take a hit, not the shield. Although I would be pleasantly surprised if it was the other way around. But yeah, I am such a sucker for a good bass lick. All right, we should be getting the halfway point, at which point this level is going to change aesthetic entirely. God, I love this. This is still so beautiful. This hasn't aged a day. I'll tell you what has aged a day, though. These little pickups. These little controllers I'm picking up, that's a Gravis gamepad. The Gravis gamepad was like the first controller for PC. I remember Jazz Jackrabbit and the Gravis gamepad really had a simpatico relationship. Like, they were really bedfellows. And it was kind of the first Super Nintendo style controller I remember seeing for a PC game. And it plugged into your parallel port. Now, kids, why don't you quit walking around on my lawn long enough for me to tell you about parallel ports? There's not much to tell. They're just what you plug things into before USB ports. That's pretty much it. I'm trying not to get tagged by a laser here. But yeah. Oh my god. That little hole there is stupid. Ow! Yep. Yep, I still have my shield. I knew the bird was going to be the first casualty if I got hit. Son of a gun. Oh well. There's plenty of opportunities to get bird. We will see that little weird alien pheasant many more times before this game is over. Let us pick up all the Gravis game pads and make our way out of this first level. I think past these barriers, that's it. Moving on to Act 2. I don't really take too much stock in getting all the items in Jazz Jackrabbit. Number one, I don't care about points. And number two, I think in a lot of levels, the calculation for how you get items is broken. So, oh yeah, we're right into the black and blue on this one. Anything in here? No. We will try coming back here later. I always liked these spark enemies. I thought they were really creepy. Creepier than boos, in fact, which they behave like. Yeah, not much. I've said there's a lot of Sonic DNA in this game. Not much Mario, actually, though. There is virtually no resemblance between Jazz Jackrabbit and Mario. You will never see them probably talked about in the same breath, except for here while I'm doing it right now. So let's go ahead, blah-ba-boom. Alrighty, follow me over here so that I can shoot you out of existence, because bullets have always worked on electricity. It's a tale as old as time. Let's go ahead, and I think if I go to the left here is where the real goodies are. Not in here, maybe. Yeah, here we go. There was a whole room I saw to the side. Yeah, let's leave some stars for when we get out of here. Rapid fire, very important. I am against turtles. I will even kill the baby turtles. I always liked that the lore behind Jazz Jackrabbit was that it's like the tortoise and the hare, but it's the future and they still have a lot of enmity toward each other. I stole that word from the Wikipedia article about the game. Enmity. I mean, what can I say? It's just a good word. All right, drop in, say hello. Hi, how you doing? Okay. We don't want to skip. I think there's some pretty nice stuff. Yeah, rapid fire. I think the maximum on rapid fires is 10. Okay. Oh, hey. Ooh, no. Enemies do have pretty giant hitboxes in this game, as I recall. But there's no value in skipping when I can just pick up strips of celluloid divested from their original films and from all context whatsoever. I should have picked up a yummy. Okay, there we go. Alright, yeah. Rapid fire is pretty good. If you die, you lose all your rapid fires, which is bad. Because rapid fire, you can lay down some pretty good cover fire, even just with your pea shooter. I rarely switch guns in this game. I rarely play with any of the other ammo, even though I have, like, God knows I have plenty of it. Like, look at these toasters. They're humongous. And I have nearly... Do I have 999 of them already? Oh my gosh. Yeah, I have tons of specialized ammo. So, like, I don't know. Why not? What am I doing, Jazz? I'm shuffling through my ammunition supplies. There we go. Now, there we go. I rarely use that stuff. So, why not take a chance to play a little bit differently? Oh, yeah. And also, let's see. Can I get their hitbox with anything like the launcher? No. Yeah, I didn't think I was gonna... I knew I was gonna make a hash out of that. Okay, alright. Well, moving on. So, woo! Bonus stage. I love the bonus stages in this game, too. They're quite often... Now, that is one place where it does unabashedly rip off Sonic the Hedgehog. Specifically Sonic CD. Although, Jazz Jackrabbit's bonus stages are a hell of a lot better than Sonic CDs. Sonic CDs are chunky, paste, mild salsa. I hate them with my life. I always thought this was the coolest pose on Earth. Though what I didn't understand was why the characters always look so strung out in this game. Get 30 gems. Man, this is a smooth running experience right here. And man, just that driving music. There's hardly a song in Jazz Jackrabbit that isn't great. Okay, so we want to jump over hands that tell us not to go somewhere. You're trying to keep us away from delicious blue gems. Bonus game, what are you doing? I will try to play the bonus games where possible, and I might show them off in the little gated off individualized section that they have at the end of the... There we go. Oh god, his eyes are so far apart. It's so weird.